I'm Jake Heffernan. This past summer, I was a deckhand aboard the 1,000-foot-long iron ore freighter Stewart J. Cort. We loaded in Superior, Wisconsin, and unloaded in Burns Harbor, Indiana. Between Lake Superior and Lake Huron is a small upper Michigan city called Sault, Ste. Marie. This is the location of the Soo Locks. The locks, owned and operated by the Army Corps of Engineers, raise and lower both cargo ships and pleasure boats to 21 feet between Lake Superior and Lake Huron. The locks were built in 1855 and have been a vital part of Great Lakes shipping ever since. If it weren't for the locks, major ports like Marquette and Duluth Superior would be inaccessible from the rest of the Great Lakes. The locks operate from March to January, and between the two operating locks, over 10,000 ships pass through every year. As a deckhand, I was partly responsible for ensuring our passage went smoothly. Before we approached the lock, we would run out the thick steel cables that would hold the ship in place while we locked through. When we came alongside the approach wall, we were then lowered onto the dock on what's called a bosun's chair. We then walked alongside the ship and into the lock. Once the ship was inside the lock, the massive gates would close behind us, and we would assist the lock hand in securing the ship. The locks work mainly by gravity. This diagram shows what happens when a ship is coming from Superior to Huron or downbound. The upper gates are open and the ship sails into the lock. The upper gate is then closed along with the filling valve. The emptying valve is then opened, allowing the water to flow out of the lock. Once the ship has been lowered, the lower gates open and the ship sails on. For upbound ships, the process is simply reversed. This is a time lapse of the 1,000 foot long Indiana Harbor downbound at the Soo. To wrap this up, here's some pictures that I took while aboard the Stewart J. Cort. Thank you.